We're going to see how to use arrays and dictionaries with Swift. I'm going to start out with an array, and an array allows you to create a collection of objects that are just single objects per item in the array, whereas a dictionary is a key value, so you have a key for each item in the array associated to a value. This lets you access the key and pull out the value, whereas the array, you just have to send in the number of the item, so the index of that item, and you get the value back. There's not a key value association except for the implicit index, whereas with the dictionary, you can actually name your key. So let's see how this works. So I've got the standard playground text here that I don't really need, and I'm going to create an array that's going to be a var. So I'll just say array, and what I want to do is add some cars. So, or some car types. So I'll do like a Ford, and then I'll do something like a Porsche, and then I'll add a Volvo. So there's three items in my array. They're all strings. Now let's just pull out one of these items. I want a car. So to do that, I just say array, and I'm going to pull out the second item. And then you'll see what happens over here. I get a Porsche. And you can see my array is also containing all these different strings. So you might be wondering, well, if I'm pulling out item one, why is it not getting the Ford instead of the Porsche? These are zero-based indexes, so everything starts at zero. Now, if I change this, I can get the Ford out. So that is a basic array. Now, let's contrast this with how the dictionary works. So I'm just going to abbreviate this and do something like, I'll call it Ford, and then I'll do a, let's see, Focus. Then I'll do Porsche, and I'll do a 944, then I'll do the Volvo. And I'll just do something like a S40. Okay, and that completes the dictionary. So you can see here we have these keys, which are Ford, Porsche, and Volvo, and they're associated to particular values. So how do I get something out of here? So I'm going to do var car2, or let's say above we have our regular type, and we're going to do car specific. So here I'm going to do dict. Then I'll just access a key, let's say Volvo, and that's going to pull out a Volvo, if I spell it right. So I get the S40, and that is the difference between the array and the dictionary. Now there's a few other things you can do with these. So let's say I have my array, and I want to assign something different for the first item. So this can be 0. Index 0 equals Chevy. So then if I do car2 and I access array 0, we get the Chevy and not the Ford this time, whereas up here you can see we did get the Ford. And I can also do something like array, append, and then I can add the Ford back. So now we have four items. Now if I want, I can do array remove at index, and then I can do 3, which will remove the Ford. So if we look at this again, I can do var car3 equals array, and let's try to add access element 3. So you can see we're actually getting nothing, but let's access element 2, and we get the Volvo, which is the last one in our array. And if I want to see the entire array, I can just do this. And now we can see what we have inside of our array, how it may have changed from what the original was. And for the dictionary, just going to access our variable here, I can say something like Ford, which is the first item, and then I can just assign, instead of a Focus, I might want to assign something like F-150. And now if I look at the dictionary, you can see we have a different set of items than what we started out with. So here's what we started out with, and we have the Ford back here. And now we have the Ford F-150. Or you can see the Focus here. And now we've changed that. And if we want to add a new item, so let's just call this Toyota. And this item is going to be Camry. Now if we print line again, we'll see we've increased our dictionary. So I'm just going to look at the whole thing here. We have four cars, and here's the Toyota and the Camry. And of course, you can get access to it. So I'll do something like var car 4 equals dict Toyota. And I get the Camry. And you can see with the dictionary, I don't have to be concerned at all about index numbers. I just go for the key, and I get the item that's associated with that key. So that's a quick look at how to create and manipulate arrays and dictionaries using Swift.